So we are discussing about air, wind and cyclone. So yesterday I gave a few important questions. Today we are going with the remaining some of the questions which are important for your examination. In that, the first one is suggest two methods to find wind direction. For this, use minuend, suggest two methods to find the wind direction. In wind direction, already we discussed anemometer. We will use anemometer to find the wind direction, whether it is blowing to east or west. For the two methods I told, one is of paper cup, the second method is prepare an cardboard arrow mark and find out the wind direction. Okay, whether when you are taking four paper cups and to one paper cup you have to follow that one, and you can see that when it is rotating, it stops at a particular point. That particular point, what it will say means it is in that particular direction. Means if it stops near to the east, so the wind blows to eastern direction. If it stops near west, the wind blows to western direction. So here, what are the points given here? Suggest two methods to find wind direction means we use wind vane. It turns in the direction of the wind. The second method is observe the direction in which a paper plane flies. You will throw up the rockets like that. In that one, in which direction that paper rocket will fly, according to that the wind direction is there, you can find out. That is the direction of the wind. If we feel the difficulty in riding a bicycle, when we will feel difficulty? When the air is opposite to us. Means when I am riding a bicycle, if the air is opposite to me, for suppose if I am riding to east, so the wind is opposite to me, means it is blowing from west direction. Did you understand? I am moving in east direction. To my opposite, the wind blows. The wind is to west direction. So here we feel difficulty in riding a bicycle opposite to the direction of the wind. These are the three points. First one is we use wind vane. It turns in the direction of the wind. The second one is observe the direction in which a paper plane flies, that is the direction of the wind. Third one is, we feel difficulty in riding a bicycle opposite to the direction of the wind. Okay, now next question. Here comes the second question for you. This is very important answer, which always repeats in the exam. Explain why holes are made in hoardings and banner hangings in the open, means in the open space. So see here, the next one. Explain why holes are made in the hoardings and banners hanging in the open. We can see that when elections are coming, or when a hero birthday was there, or some ads like shampoos or soaps are there. So we can see on the highways near to the bridges or on the roadsides, when Ganesh Chaturthi is there, the best thing, youth will take the photographs and tie the banners on the roadside. When the air blows, what will happen? That particular banners will fly away. Okay, what we have to do? Because of the wind blow, they will fly. We have to stop them. How can we? Means to that banners, to the all the sides, four sides, we have to keep holes. when we are keeping holes to them, what will happen means when the wind blows through that holes, the wind will go and it stops the banner not to fall down. If you are not giving holes to that banners or hoardings, what will happen means when the wind blows, they will automatically fall on someone and hurt someone. But hoardings means it is very horrible. Banners means we can adjust. Or if while we are traveling on some vehicle, if the banner comes and falls on our face, what will happen? We cannot see what is going front. So many accidents will be happening. If it is hoardings means they will tie with the wooden sticks and all. If they fall on our head, it will harm the people. So what we have to do when we are tying these hoardings and banners, we have to put holes to them. Did you understand? So see here, explain why holes are made in the hoardings and banner hanging in the open. For that, moving air, which is otherwise called wind, exerts pressure on the banners and hoardings, so which obstruct their path. The force of the wind will tear away the banners or make the hoardings fall. If there are holes on the banners or hoardings, the air passes through them unobstructed. So got the point? Moving air, which is otherwise called wind, exerts pressure on the banners and hoardings which obstruct their path. The force of the wind will tear away the banners or make the hoardings fall. If there are holes on the banners or hoardings, the air passes through them unobstructed. We shall go to next one. Is state two experiences. State two experiences that make you think that air exists pressure. For this, the answer is first one, a flame always So the next one is stage 2 exam experiences that make you think that air exists pressure. In that, the two examples are a flame always points upwards. This is because the air pushes it upward. Then the hot air from the surroundings of the fire goes up and it pushes the flame upwards. So the second example is the aeroplane works by the upward thrust of air. Air pushes the plane up from under the wings. Birds also fly in the same way. These two examples. One is the flame always moves in upward direction. The second one is the air pushes the aeroplane upwards. Even in the same way, the birds also fly. These two are the examples for air exists pressure. Not only these two examples, many examples are there. You can write that one. And tomorrow we will go with the even and uneven heating of wind. Thank you.